There are at least 40 million victims of human trafficking right now globally, according to the United States Official Department of Homeland Security. Human trafficking involves the use of force, fraud, or coercion to obtain some type of labor or commercial sex act.
Sex trafficking. We like to talk about numbers. $45 million spent per year in the U.S. for online sex trafficking alone. 21 million people enslaved globally. 300,000, that's the number of U.S. children at risk for human trafficking each year. That's 300 of these slides with 1,000 figures, and it's enough to fill Citizen Bank Park almost seven times over. $200,000 per year is what a pimp stands to make from just one victim. 15 years. That's the age by which most child victims are lured into sex trafficking. 15 years old, that's ninth grade. But I'd like to get away from the numbers, which are somewhat unreliable and likely the tip of the iceberg in many cases. See, when we try to count these traffickers, when we see them, they vanish, they scatter, they morph, they change into the nice lady down the street, or her uncle, his boss, her boyfriend. They live among us, and so do their victims.
The speaker in the video clip that was just presented is Kanani Tichton. Kanani Tichton is a pediatrician who has made it her goal to eradicate human trafficking. She has gone through years of training to spot signs of human trafficking, which has allowed her to notice many victims in her practice. She has been able to help many victims escape and move on to their next step in life. Dr. Tichton is an inspiration to me. My name is Emmalynn Boulton, and it is my mission to bring awareness to human trafficking. I have conducted a survey to assess the level of education of my peers in Michigan in regards to human trafficking. 90% of the people who took my survey admitted to being uneducated about human trafficking, not having been formally taught about it ever. 94% of the survey participants argued that human trafficking lessons should be present in school. In addition to this, 100% of the people who took my survey agreed that it is important for all people to be aware of human trafficking. These telephone numbers may or may not be familiar to you. Both phone numbers were retrieved from America's official website of the Department of Homeland Security. The phone number on the left, 1-866-347-2423, is used to report any suspicions of human trafficking, whether that is forced human labor or forced human sex trafficking. The number displayed on the right-hand side of the screen is intended to be used for victims of human trafficking or those trying to find help for victims. This number can provide various resources specific to each caller's needs. For immediate help, call 911. If you were to witness human trafficking, the first thing you should do is call 911, then achieve safety for yourself and the victim or victims. 911 will provide the fastest response. You can identify human trafficking by being aware of the signs. Someone who is more vulnerable than others may be more susceptible to human trafficking. Someone who is alone often is more vulnerable, especially if they are a young adult. You or a friend could be a victim if you realize that you are feeling trapped in a relationship or partnership of any kind and are coerced or forced to engage in activities for the gain of that partner. Traffickers may promise a safe haven, money, or other supposedly great opportunities in exchange for labor or sex acts, but traffickers will not follow through. Being deceived with false promises is a sign of human trafficking. If a friend suddenly cuts ties with loved ones, it is possible that they have been trafficked. Traffickers will often threaten the victim and their family, which could cause victims to cut off their families. In addition to this, traffickers may purposely eliminate access to the victim's family by taking away means of communication. Another sign that you or someone you know may be a victim of human trafficking is if the person is feeling pressured into doing things they wouldn't want to do. Coercion is being persuaded by force or threats. Also, many victims of human trafficking get trapped into it because of language barriers. Someone who cannot ask for help is at a higher risk of being trafficked. Katarina Rosenblatt is an advocate for human trafficking victims. She herself was trafficked as a young girl. She escaped that life and has chosen to use her experience to help others.
And she wandered alone. Soon enough, there was a trafficking ring that spotted my vulnerability, being alone, having low self-esteem coming from a dysfunctional home life. You know, they spotted that. And so there was an older girl that recruited me.
It is crucial for everyone to be aware of human trafficking. Knowing who is at risk and how to identify signs of human trafficking can save millions of victims. If you suspect human trafficking, call 1-888-373-7888. For more information, go to dhs.gov. Just like Dr. Kanani Tichton and Katarina Rosenblatt, you can make a difference and help eradicate human trafficking. Thank you for listening to this visual essay, Spread Awareness and Stop Human Trafficking.